Do you have enough light for them? It all piles up. Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, she really has.
She had to have a big 40-50 party. Friday night.
Oh, just really?
Best job, I think. One wow. Time I tailed off at the end.
Missing?
What's that?
I'm missing. I thought I had the whole rehearsal schedule and the rundown of the show and what happens when, but that's gone.
Oh. Do you need it?
You want to go? You want to go to a balcony?
Yeah.
Are they open already?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hitting the bottle.
Yeah. We all relax in different ways.
It's cold out here. Is it cold?
It's freezing.
I think, is it Dale?
And actually.
Do you have a second?
Can I move stuff around?
I think we're going to try to run this sort of like a radio show such that there's not the empty stages between the ads. And therefore, Jack,
yes.
I guess while the pause is going on,
automatic. Thank you.
Thank you. and liquid for men. I use oil rig every day and it keeps my hands red, rough, and cracked. The other night at Slim's, I took the biggest pot of the night with a pair of deuces. The boys didn't know what hit them, thanks to oil rig.
Yet it's only a cent for men to do their share in the home workplace, but don't want their hands to show it.
Whatever. Here with us on stage is Ralph Akbaum, the Chief Executive Officer of Bungee Plungers, our sponsor during this portion of the show. Bungee Plungers, is that right?
Yeah, what else would it be? It's Bungee Plungers, and we help people do bungee plunging.
Got a question for you, Ralph. I suppose it's based on ignorance. Would it be fair to say that bungee plunging is bungee jumping with a twist?
Never say twist in the bungee business, Bob. Wrinkle would be better. Let's say we've got a new wrinkle we've developed over there at Bungee Plungers.
Now, we don't have unlimited time here, Ralph, and since you're here to advertise your service, would you mind explaining the nature of bungee plunging to your potential customers in the audience?
Well, let me start by asking you a question, Bob. Just how many people want to be lifted into the sky on a shaky crane and stand on a platform 120 feet in the air and then fall off and let a rubber band catch them before they conk their heads?
Nobody I know of. Certainly not me. Well, I'm even careful climbing out of bed, especially climbing out of bed. It's a pretty dangerous time.
Very interesting, Bob. But here's the answer. Most people won't jump from a wobbly crane in the sky for one good reason. They're afraid of heights. I'm afraid of heights myself, but I'm not afraid of depths. And that's the key to bungee plungers. A bungee plunger customer stands on the ground, not on some flimsy, wavering platform.
Now, standing on the ground, I can handle.
Well, you stand on the ground at the edge of a big hole in the ground. Get it?
Yeah. Not dumb.
The bungee cords are attached to your legs. The rest is as easy as falling over. Some people walk, well, they more like a waddle because the cords are attached to their legs. And they waddle toward the big hole with their head turned back and pretend they just accidentally walked into it. Whatever works. We have three locations in the Twin Cities area. Just look for the sign with the big arrow pointing down toward the big hole. 120 feet deep or more, really.
How do you get the people out of the holes after they've taken the bungee plunge? Or you just leave them in there?
A little humor, huh, Bob? Right now, to address the customer removal question, right now, until we come up with something better, we drag the plungers back up by the feet with the bungee cords.
By their feet? Upside down? Won't they be banging against the walls of the hole?
Well, they could, I suppose, but most of them don't, because what they do is they press their hands against the wall as we instruct in a sort of walking motion as they come up. This helps control the abrasions.
Well, it seems to me that would discourage your customers, that rather primitive retrieval concept.
Well, on the face of it, I suppose, but the deal is, it's all part of the bungee plunging adventure. Anyway, you're going to know pretty soon, Bob, because it's my privilege, got it in my billfold, to present you with two free tickets for bungee plunger plunges at our plunger site number 3. It's an abandoned coal mine north of Anoka. It's our deepest plunge, so retail value, $80.
I'll think about it and get back to you.
Well, I certainly hope so. Now, there's no time for thinking, Bob. Thinking is always bad in the bungee business. If you don't want these free tickets, I'll just give you some daring soul who doesn't mind a little risk, somebody with courage and leadership ability.
You've taken a wrong turn here, Ralph. And besides, your time is up. We thank you and Bungee Plungers Incorporated for sponsoring this portion of the show, I think. Any last word?
I'll just say again. Ask yourself this, folks. Would you rather fall off a shaky wooden platform suspended 120 feet in the air, or stand with both feet planted solidly on good old pomme de terre, and just fall into a big dark hole 120 feet deep?
You mean terra firma, Ralph. Pomme de terre are potatoes. Your customers stand on potatoes before the plunge?
More humor at my expense, huh, Bob? I'm getting out of here.
Bungee plungers. Look for the big deep hole near the NPR booth at the State Fair next year.
Canada, or you asked me if you'd be offering the tickets and stuff. Okay. What do you think if I take kind of a long Jack Benny type pause there and just kind of let it sit? I don't know.
Okay, that's fine with me. Yeah. I won't say a word until I notice you. gets around.
Oh, you're... The one thing I'm concerned about with the one that we do together is that the audience that doesn't know that I'm foreign, will they pick up on it right away or just have to wait until you said that I'm foreign?
Oh, my travels.
Here, I can show you. Thank you.
Okay, good idea. Well, look, most of them are in here listening, and they all know that you're foreign. See, even works on cable from where you want to be from.
Oh, I'm an Australian. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I totally
care. Let me just write that in.
Just a two-man show. What is it again?
Whatever. I can't hear.
It's taking a couple of from
you. Yeah.
Is it working?
Yeah. A lot of solo piano stuff I've got.
That deal.
Deal.
Introduce it.
This. I think it's going to be three cabins. go redeem it and buy some more.